Let's wait for it to set.
Hi.
Hi.
Good afternoon. I'm Angela.
I'm Kelly.
And this is the Muscle of Yarn podcast.
It is.
Where we talk about knitting and yarn.
Someday and spinning, because yep. I spin, but we haven't brought it.
And sometimes lots of other things.
Yeah. But we've got a lot of yarny goodness to talk about today.
We're very excited.
A lot of yarny goodness. So.
Can't wait. So we should probably get started. You can find me on Instagram and Ravelry as Junior Bird Kid.
And I'm on Ravelry as Kelly Spins and Instagram as Kelly O Spins.
And you can find our store, Must Love Yarn, in Shelburne, Vermont, if you're local to us in Vermont or traveling through. Yep. But you can find us out on social media everywhere as Must
Instagram,
Love Yarn.
Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, our website.
Ravelry.
Ravelry. You name it, we're probably there.
Probably just do a Google search for Must Love Yarn and hopefully.
And we
will pop up.
Yep. Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So we've been busy and had a lot of stuff going on.
And you and Jen went to TNNA.
We went to TNNA, and I have a bunch of stuff to show you, but to kind of keep this under an hour, we may have to split it up, but we will do as much as we can, and I've got a couple FOs. I've got, as usual, a bunch of works in progress.
Yes. And as you can see, I'm still here, so we have not gone to the split screen mode, or we're not filming at, say, my house.
Yeah.
So we're still...
No ninja yet.
No ninja yet. Any day, we're in the red zone.
Yes, we are. I know. I was saying to Carol, I'm like, oh my God, what if she started going into labor on the podcast?
Well, you would hear about it here first, folks. As I'd probably be uploading the video at the hospital, and my husband would be like, what are you doing? I'd be like, I've got to get the podcast out.
Ninja wants to say hi.
So if you need reason to subscribe to the podcast, maybe that's it. I don't know.
Yeah.
So what do you have for finished objects this week?
So I have two finished objects. So one you saw last week, and it's like 80 degrees today, so I'm not going to put this hat on. So I'm going to leave it on this lovely person whose head is too small.
I was just to say, it's not a very big-headed model.
I know. That's the problem with all of the ones. We have all the same ones in the store, and their heads are very small. So, and I don't have a particular big head, but, you know, I wear average-size hats. So this is a Claudia hat by MJ Kim, and I started this on the last one. I was going to start a project to be able to take with me on my trip because hats are easy. I usually don't have to pay a whole lot of attention to them. It's really pretty. The yarn is Fiber Stash, and it's her burnt orange colorway. It's her worsted superwash base.
It's really nice.
It's really, really pretty. So it's a nice hat. It's fun. And it looks really cool all done up. And, so I started this, I think on Monday or Tuesday before we left, and I finished it on the plane into Dulles. So we flew into Dulles.
Nice.
And before the wheels hit the ground, I had all the ends woven in and everything. So as you can see, it didn't make it very long into TNNA. But I started another one, and I made a hat on Friday, all in one day. I cast it on, so I'll show you that one too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you have FOs? I do. I have one.
Oh, you finished it.
I did. So
oh, pretty.
And it's huge. So this is Pure Joy.
Oh my gosh.
By Hohe Locatelli. So it's knit with short rows. So the stripes start at this end.
Oh, that's very cool.
And you have the short rows. I did make one modification, and that was I added another eyelet row at the edge. The pattern doesn't actually call for that. But I had extra purple yarn, and so I thought, why not?
I like that.
Why not? So I'll get this put up on like one of the mannequins and take a picture of it so you can see how it looks when you wear it. It was a great knit, very really fun, great way to use a couple of skeins of sock yarn. And
I love this purple. It's so pretty.
I think, you know, for folks who haven't done a lot of color work, this might be a really good project. You don't have to weave an end. You can carry them up the sides here because of how the short rows work with this. So if you're looking to try maybe some color work but don't want to have to have, you know, 600 million ends.
Yeah.
This is probably a great pattern to at least get started. It's also good for practicing short rows.
Yeah.
And it's quick. It's all garter stitch for the most part.
What kind of short rows does she have you
It's used? Just a simple wrap and turn. And because it's garter stitch, you actually don't have to pick up the wraps.
Yep. Yeah, and a lot of designers will actually do that when you have garter stitch because the wrap just looks like a garter bump.
Yep.
So that you don't have to pick up the wrap, which is nice because then you can just keep on knitting and not even have to
really pay attention.
Right,
you don't have to look for it.
Yeah.
So.
That's beautiful.
Anyway, so that one is done.
Very nice.
It's been washed and blocked, and I had a really hard time finding a spot in my house where I could lay it out.
So you didn't have kitties laying on it and dogs.
Exactly.
And children.
Or child. Yeah, exactly.
My cat, I don't know what it is about the wet fabric of yarn. She loves it.
Yeah.
And all she wants to do is just spread herself out across it.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't do anything to it. She just wants to lay on it.
Yeah, it's the weirdest.
It's really bizarre.
It is.
Yeah.
So that's my one finished object. I am happy to report that Gather Together, the ongoing saga, right? That's the right term. Yeah, Gather Together. The button band has been re-knit.
Oh, you did? Oh, you already got it all off and re-knit.
Off and re-knit.
Wow.
I have 5 out of the 11 buttons sewn on,
so I have
6 more buttons to go.
You should wait to do that until after Stash Dash.
It already started. Stash Dash started at the end of May.
No, I know, but the button part of it. Like, leave the buttons, because they don't have to be on.
Oh, yeah, I know. But I wanted to make sure that solution was going to work.
Yeah.
So I had the top 5 buttons, and it's...
And that was the section that was off.
Yeah, it's matching up
now.
So my hope is to get the other 6 buttons sewn on in short order, because then I can bring it in. It can be a shop sample.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
So, yeah.
Oh, good.
Yay! If I get it done... I'll get it on a mannequin, take a picture. It'll probably be next week. Never mind. I'm not going to insert it here. Because it's not going on me, that's for sure.
Aww.
Yeah.
Your little baby bump be popping out.
Or my mom will be here on Saturday. Maybe I'll make her take a picture of her. But I'd like to have the podcast uploaded before Saturday. So.
Yeah, so we'll link it anyway. So.
Yeah. It'll be up on my project page.
Yeah. Yeah.
So. Cool. So that one's close.
Very nice.
But I didn't want to schlep it in. I didn't even weave in the ends because I was so unsure whether that was actually going to work. I was like, I'm not weaving in the ends and finding them again if this is not going to work.
Yeah, no, I don't blame you.
I don't know what plan B was, but...
Zipper?
Leave the buttons off. Yeah, zipper. Yeah.
Zipper.
Might have been.
Or leave it open.
Yeah. It doesn't look as good open, though. It's definitely one of those cardigans that needs to be
closed. Some sort of a closure. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So,
I have one other FO, which is a very simple. I showed you the yarn and the pattern for this last time. This is the Spicer hat and Blue Sky Fibers. They're wool stock yarn, which is 100% Peruvian Highland wool. And it comes in a lot of different colors in the 50 gram skeins. So you can do color work. And then it comes in 5 colors in 150 gram skeins. So you can do sweaters.
And the price point on that is... pretty good, right? The 150 grand skeins are a little bit over $20.
I've got to look it up.
That one's about 8-ish, I think, the 50 gram.
Yeah, I meant to look it up and I haven't. But they're really, the colors are really lovely. It's kind of like a heathered, it has a heathered look to it. And this hat knit up, I knit this on Friday when I was in one of my classes.
It's a good knit for...
because it's just all stock in it, you know, once you go, and so it was really easy, and it was fun. It's a quick knit, so we don't have this yarn in the store yet, but it's one that we're looking to bring in, so stay tuned for that.
It would be a good option.
Yeah. The hat pattern is a free pattern, and I believe it's up on Ravelry now.
Well, and also let us know. Is this something you'd like to see a stock in the store?
Yeah, if you're interested in doing color work on sweaters.
Or even felting, because it's not super wash,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's not super wash. Okay. It's really squishy, and it stays squishy when you knit.
Like, when you think of, Highland wool, a lot of times I think it's, maybe it's a little scratchy. This is not.
It's not. It's really soft. I mean, I'm not terribly sensitive to wool, but I could wear this up against my skin, and it wouldn't bother me. But, yeah, it's really lovely. And it was a fun, fast knit. So if you're looking for just a quick hat pattern, we'll link to this in show notes, too. So.
Excellent.
That's my end of my FOs. I finally have some.
Well, because also Fiber Stash Christy, any of her, like, her variegated would be lovely, because it's a simple pattern.
And it would show off her yarn. She's got some really pretty variegated yarns that would look really lovely in a nice basic pattern like this. Yeah. And they knit up so quick, they're great for presents. So if you want to start building up your Christmas box of gifts.
I don't know. Yeah. I prefer to wait till like Thanksgiving and then realize I have approximately 3 weeks to do.
I've got plenty of time. Oh,
time.
Yeah, I know.
And then there's lots of really late nights and snarly.
Or gift cards.
Or wrapping up balls of yarn with things on the needles.
Yeah.
And being like, can I have that back now?
I know.
So I can finish it.
I know. Yep. So what you got on the needle?
So I picked up Featherweight again.
Oh, me too.
Because I just got in a groove with Pure Joy, and so I really wanted to just get it done. So I picked this up, and I got the body completely knit all the way down. And I opted to do a 1x1 rib, but I chose to do a knit through the back loop.
Twisted
rib.
Yep.
So it's pretty open. It creates a nice little design element on the sweater itself.
Yep.
And I wasn't sure if I liked it or not, but I think the longer I look at it, the more I actually like it, because it just provides a little bit more contrast.
I like
down
it.
There.
Yeah, I think it's really cute.
And then I have the first sleeve, because I remember I was going to do short sleeves.
Oh, right.
So the first sleeve, I'm already working on the ribbing on it. Probably another half inch or so. I wasn't going to do a full 2 inches on the sleeve, probably just an inch.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have the second sleeve to finish, and then I'll do the same twisted ribbing for picking up around the button band.
Yeah.
Or I guess it's not really a button band, but the band. So getting close.
Nice.
And this one, I mean, it's a quick knit.
Yeah.
Why don't you just sit and go? And actually, after knitting like the 350 stitches per row,
you're like, wow, my sleeves are flying.
This feels like it's going really fast. Yeah. And I am using the small circulars.
Yep, 9-inch. Yep.
9-inch as well. I actually like them.
I really like them.
Yeah.
I started some socks with them too, and I really like them.
Yeah. I've been very pleased. So. Yeah. This may be my new go-to for sleeves.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Nice. Well, since we're talking about Featherweight, I will grab mine. It's going quite well. I hadn't worked on it forever, and I didn't take this with me because it was...
Well, that was interesting.
I don't even know if you could see that on the camera or not, but she opened her water and water was flying out. Mine does that on
a water spout. That might be the title of this one.
The water spout. Oh, my gosh. It's better than... My water just broke!
We should probably stick with the water spout.
Water spout, yeah. I think I showed you before. I only have just a couple more stripe sections to go, and then I'm gonna do the ribbing. So there's my sleeve.
Nice.
It's coming along. So it's I'm getting there. I'm getting there. But it's like 3/4 length sleeve right now. But and I have 100 million ends to weave. Well, not 100 million. I have a lot of ends to weave in once I get done. But it's really nice and soft. It's going to be a great sweater. It'll be nice just to, you know, throw over like a short sleeve shirt like this or a tank top or something. But I can also, you know, it can transition into fall with a long sleeve underneath. There's, you know, the sleeves did fit snugly, but there's a lot of room there.
It's
so it'll go really well over, you know, just a long sleeve tee. So that's what I've got going with that.
Awesome.
And yeah, I have all these. I've been slowly every once in a while, like if I'm, it's not, I don't want to say I don't feel like knitting, but I'll just sit and weave in ends. If I only have like,
it's the printer.
We're going to have lots of distractions going on today. That's all right.
That's the way it goes.
It's business. So, So, yeah, every once in a while, I'll just sit. And if I only have, you know, 20 minutes or something, I don't want to pick up and start knitting. So I'll just weave in a couple ends, which is a nice way of doing it.
I sense a theme here. Kelly's picking projects with a million ends with lots of ends.
It doesn't bother, especially if I do it like that and do a little bit at a time.
I've found my tolerance level for doing things that have lots of ends to weave in is much more manageable if I just take a break during sort of the middle of the project and weave in a bunch of the ends instead of having a whole ton of them to do at the very end.
Yeah, I agree. It's a little bit easier that way. It's more manageable that way.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yep.
So the only other thing that I've been consistently working on is the socks. The Gail's Art sock blank socks. And this is sock number 2.
Nice.
And I'm just knitting the heel flap right now. So for comparison, where did sock number 1 go? We're getting it's a little, the color changes are it's a little bit different, but that's one of the fun things about the sock blanks.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, unless you get one that's double, and you're doing them at the same time, or you skein them off into balls.
Which we kind of did with this one.
Yeah.
So here's the middle portion that I ripped out to get to where it was closer.
Where we can match it up,
But it's not exact. So if you're a matchy-matchy kind of knitter and everything has to be exactly
the
same. Get the double, or this may not be the project for you. Socks, I'm not as...
Yeah, I know.
They're just fun. They're on your feet.
Exactly.
So.
So, Ange kind of pulled me to the dark side on this one. So I ended up getting a sock blank from Gail's Art, and it's funny... The design on mine is different, but the way they're knitting up, they're looking very similar. So,
I'll
show
you. Mine up.
But I have to show you this first. My mom struck again, made me another really super cute bag. Look at this. Isn't that adorable with the frogs? I picked
that's
out a
awesome.
Bunch. I went to her house and picked out a bunch of material once, but and then look at the inside.
We gotta get her to knit some bags for the store.
Knit some.
I mean, sew some.
She'd panic if you said knit some for her. All right, so the sock blank I got is Rockstar Rainbow.
Nice.
And I actually started pulling from the wrong end, and then I realized it was that one because it had the little locking stitches on it. So this is it.
Ta-da!
So it's rainbowy with lots of cute stars on it.
So she's been having lots of updates, too. It's been really
hard for me
to be, like, walk away from the
computer. She's been doing some really cool stuff. So
we just need to talk her into telling... letting us have some of her sock blanks in the store. That would be awesome and dangerous.
I know.
But look at how, so I don't know if folks remember what my sock blank looked like, but totally different. We're seeing like a lot of the same colors.
Yeah.
Which is so cool.
Which
one of the things that's so fun about these.
Yeah. And I am knitting these on the 9-inch circular. These are Chowgu. They're US-1. And I'm just flying along with them. Socks I'm sometimes really slow with, like my other ones that I haven't shown you in forever because I haven't been working on them. But yeah, so I had to start a new one. But
nice.
But I really wanted to try these needle owls out, and I really, really like working with them. So I've been zipping right along with this because it's so small and portable that I can just toss it right in a bag. It isn't a giant bag. It kind of helps keep them separated, so I know what's in which bag.
That's her story, and she's sticking to it, folks. Me, I would put like 4 pairs of socks in there. And I'd be like, why do I have 4 pairs of socks on the needles?
Yeah, well, you know.
So we also tend to enable each other. So Kelly has fallen down the rabbit hole for Gail's Art, and I joined the Shawl Society with Helen Stewart.
And she just released a week ago. She released the first pattern.
Yep.
Talisman.
So I was perusing the store today to find my yarn for that.
I haven't even started. I barely looked at the pattern because it came when I was on the plane. So
why go stash diving when
why,
you
indeed.
Come to the store? So I'll put a picture in Carol's winding the yarn for me right now. So I didn't bring it.
It's a Zen Yarn Garden yarn.
It is.
Well, we actually showed it to you when we first got it, but we'll still link to it and everything.
Yep, I'll put a picture. I'll take a picture and put a picture in so you can see it. I think it's going to be lovely. The pictures that I've seen from this pattern knitting up, I think they need a little a lighter colored
yarn.
So you can see the patterning.
Yeah.
Which is why I went with this one. There was a Malabrigo out there, a purple one that I'm still eyeballing.
Purple.
It's lovely, but I think it's too dark for this particular shawl. So maybe the next one, shawl number two,
there you go,
would be appropriate for the purple.
Which size are you doing?
I'm going to do the large.
Are you?
One skein sock shawls, I'm not a big fan of.
Unless they're a really elongated one
that
are really shallow,
right.
So it's almost more like a scarf. And they're hard to wear.
Because they don't, I can't get them to wrap around enough, mm-hmm. and you really have to wear them with a shawl pin. And although I have lots of shawl pins because I like to buy them, I don't always wear them.
Yeah.
I prefer to wear mine scarf style, mm-hmm. and it's almost impossible to do that with the one skein. So I figured I'll just get two skeins, I'll make the bigger one, and see how it goes.
You know what I was watching Legacy Knits, and Chelsea actually and Sue were talking about that, because Chelsea's been tacking the ends together, so mm-hmm. it ends up with
being
a shorter shawls, it ends up being a cowl, which is really nice, especially if you're active and moving around a lot.
Yep.
And you don't want to have a shawl pin. It's a nice way of having something that is the pattern for a shawl, but you can wear more like a cowl.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. So, you know, if you haven't watched Legacy Knits, you should check it out.
They're a great
mother-daughter team. They're great. So
funny.
Yeah. And lots of great ideas. So.
Nice.
Yeah.
So I haven't been working on anything else. I spent a lot of time finishing Pure Joy this past weekend. And then switching over to featherweight. If I can get featherweight off the needles, then I really feel like I can focus on some other stuff.
I know. I really wanted to crank away on featherweight, too. So I've been working on that. I've been trying to be pretty monogamous with that. I did work on the socks. And, of course, last week when I was gone, I worked on hats. But the only other thing, and this is going to kind of tie in, it's a yarn. So TNNA on Friday night after the fashion show was an event called Sample It, and a lot of the vendors will set up tables with some of their products, usually in kit form, so that you can take their product, try it, see if it's something you want to bring into your store, and if you do, then you already have a shop sample knit, because you've got this, you know, you've got this little Sample It.
Those vendors are so smart.
It's really, really smart, and I ended up, I found, well, I'll show you some of the yarns I found. I've found some from companies we already are buying from, which is nice because they're yarns that we don't have from those particular companies. So I thought it would be a great way to bring some more of those yarns in from each of the different companies, and we'd have samples already made up. But I did pick up a few other companies that we don't have their yarns currently from. So so one of them I already took it apart. So Feederbrook Farm. This is the label that came on it. And she had a kit set up. She had a shawl made up. There's two skeins. So it's a BFL nylon and a merino alpaca milk fiber mix. So it's really cool. And the reason it really struck me, this is one of the skeins here.
Oh, that's a lovely.
Which is just a really pretty.
Greeny, tealy.
Yeah. It has just a little bit of a heathered look to it. But the other skein, and unfortunately, I already balled it because I started working on it. Because after I made the hats, I was like, I need something to knit. But there's
oh, that's
this is
beautiful.
A really cool yarn. And it to me, the reason I picked it up is it reminds me of handspun.
Because mm-hmm.
There is some like barber polling going on in here.
Yep.
For somebody that maybe doesn't spin or don't want to get into spinning, but they want the look of a handspun, this is really, really lovely. It is mill spun.
So is one of those is the merino?
Yeah, exactly. One's
the
BFL
nylon,
merino.
And is this one the alpaca milk?
It wasn't labeled terribly well, so I don't know for 100%. So I was going to check out her website and see. So these are actually, I don't know. Let me look at the pattern and see if there's a picture on here. I think there is.
Nice.
Sorry, it got crinkled in my luggage. So there's the shawl pattern.
Oh, that's nice.
And it's really basic, simple. That's why I kind of cast it on. It's just a
one of
triangle
those
shawl, and
where the yarn's doing all the work.
Yeah, So you start out with your variegated or multicolor yarn at the top, and then you start including the solid, semi-solid yarn to do some of the stripes. So this is obviously a different color than the one that I have, but I'll show you the little. I did start knitting. So it's knit from the top down, so this is the top part that'll go up against your neck. So
oh, nice.
It does make, you know, a really nice gradual stripe. And
the Carol.
Yeah, it is Carol. So you can see it starting to kind of shift through the colors a little bit. And the yarns that are spun that way with, you know, colors of two different strands together, you know, it's like if you're a spinner, fractal spinning, where you divide up the fiber, so it does fiber shifts, but you still have that barber pulling, so it's not such a drastic change. This is kind of the way this yarn is coming out, which is really lovely. So you can do, you know, it's really gradual and but soft changes, which is really, really pretty. So I really like that. It might be one that we consider bringing into the store. I kind of want to look at her website a little bit more and talk to her.
Yeah, play around with it a bit.
Yeah. So that's a potential one. We don't have it in the store yet, but it is one that I found. And she's very sweet. So
nice.
Yeah.
Nice. So that I think the rest is all out of your bag of goodies over there.
Yeah. So yeah, I didn't have anything else on the needles. Oh, before I do that though, I do want to show something that we do have in the store, which is it's a new local to us yarn and fiber, and they're really lovely people. The yarn is gorgeous. They have a small farm in South Randolph, Vermont, which is southeast of us. It's right off of the interstate.
South of Montpelier.
Yeah, kind of central Vermont. And they've got some lovely yarns. So these are two of their yarns. It's fun. Spun at Hampton Fiber Mill, which is right in Richmond, Vermont, which is east of us too.
Local.
And yeah, it's gorgeous. So they, this is from from their sheep named Barry.
It's Barry.
And it's a Romney Border Leicester cross. It's really super squishy. It would make gorgeous sweaters, hats, mittens.
Even a nice
you name it.
Cowl.
Yeah. It's a really dark brown. It's kind of picking up a little bit more gray on here. It's a grayish brown, but it's really lovely. Super squishy. And then
I just thought of a really awesome pattern that would go with. I'm trying to remember what the name of it was.
And this.
You keep talking. I'll look it up.
This is.
Excuse me while I get on my phone. I don't normally like to do this, but.
100% Romney, and this is from Two Youths, and it's Inanna and Ishtar, and there's a picture. They're so cute. So we do have this in the store. We've got it up on our website too, so if it's something that you're interested, if you're not local and you're interested in having us ship to you, then we can certainly do that. And their fiber, their sheep are organically raised, if that's important to you. I know some people, it's very important that, you know, they know how the wool, the sheep are cared for. And the other thing that we got from them is fiber. We're starting to bring some more fiber in. I'm a spinner, Carol's a spinner, and
like to be a spinner.
Yeah, Ange wants to be a spinner. And we're starting to start bringing some more fiber into the store, whether it's local. We do have some of the Malabrigo Nube, which is hand-painted by Malabrigo. It's really lovely. So we do have that as well if you want some bright, fun colors. But this is adorable. So when I talked to Elizabeth, who's one of the owners of Sunny Hill Farm, I don't think I mentioned the name. Sunny Hill Farm is the farm that I just showed you the yarn from. She asked me about, you know, packaging and how to sell it and things like that. And I said, you know, it's really important to have some good packaging that really draws people and speaks to people. I'm pretty sure, I didn't ask her, I wasn't here when she dropped off the fiber, but she did cards. She left me a really nice card, and I'm pretty sure that she did all of the artwork for this bag too. It's like a nice block printed bag. And so the the fiber that's in this one, this is, I'm pretty sure the gray is the border luster. Yep, this is a border luster fleece. It's a nice kind of light gray fleece, roving, all ready to spin. And it comes in this great bag. And we do have the natural white, which is 100% Romney. And so you get this fun bag. So when you're done spinning your fiber, then you've got a great project bag. Or you can, you know, if you're spindle spinning, you can keep your spindle right in here with your roving. And if you're spinning from a wheel, this can sit down next to you and you can pull right from it and keep your fiber nice and clean. So great, great company, great local product, and nice, nice. Well,
did you oatmeal stout?
Oatmeal. Oh yeah. Okay. Yeah.
So it's meant to be knit with Clara Parks's CBM Romney Dell yarn. So it takes 3 skeins, 3 different colors, but it's enough to make a cowl, infinity scarf, and mittens.
Wow.
And it's set up. We'll see. We'll link the pattern.
Yeah, we can maybe pop up picture.
But it's definitely meant for this type of really squishy.
Yeah.
Squishy wool. So let me just see if we can do this.
We might be able to get it in. Yeah.
I think that we can.
Yeah.
So we'll link to it in the show notes. You can find it on Ravelry. And but that yarn would make a really good oatmeal stout.
Yeah. That would. All right. So moving on to more fun stuff. So before we ended up leaving for TNNA, I got a telephone call from Linda, who's one of the owners of Denise Interchangeable Knitting and Crochet Needles and Hooks. She was very lovely. She actually has ties to Burlington, and her brother-in-law is actually the one who's spearheading the research facility at the University of Vermont that's doing the breast cancer research, and they've made major strides in it. You'll see a lot of the cast-off chemo logos in some things. The Cat Bordy book, the slipper book, the proceeds of that went to the went directly to the research lab, and that I think Linda told me has raised $50,000 to go to the lab. And the Denise actually has a cast off chemo sets of needles and hooks. And they've raised, I think she said, $200,000 to go to the research for that lab.
Wow.
But they're making really great strides in cancer research and how to treat it without having to use chemo, and so your body actually is attacking the cancer. So when I stopped in, she wanted me to stop at her booth and say hi, because she's going to be up here in July, and
she going to pop into the store?
She's going to stop in and say hi to us. But they are working with a number of companies that are doing a lot of really good things to help create donations. And one of them is, a lot of you hand dyers out there will know Wool to Dye For. She produces, she's a supplier of raw, undyed wool and fiber. And she came up with a colorway and she dyed a bunch up. And these are for sale by donation, basically. And so I got a couple of them because there's a whole bunch of patterns that were written to show off this yarn. And so all of the proceeds of this yarn is going directly to that cancer research lab. And Linda has a lot of this yarn, so when she comes up in July, she's going to bring some up for us to have here in the store, so people can come in and get this for donation, and we'll have some of the patterns available for you. And so I'm going to knit at least one, maybe 2 samples up. I've got a couple skeins of this.
That would be great.
Actually, I'm probably going to crochet one too, because we did bring in some of the Denise interchangeable crochet hooks. We've had some people who have been looking for the crochet hooks for Tunisian crochet. Oh, you can use them for regular crochet as well. So we did bring some of those in, and they're some of the money from the sale of those crochet hooks also goes to the cancer research.
Excellent.
So, yeah. So we've got this, and I just want to give you guys a heads up that we're going to
have this in July.
We're going to be getting these in July. So for a $20 donation, you get a skein of yarn. It's a 80/20 merino nylon base, 400 yards, 100-gram skein, so you can do shawls, scarves,
socks.
Yeah, you can do a lot of fun things
cowl
with this, and the money is going to really good use. I mean, it's going directly to the lab and they can use it and they're making wonderful strides and it's close to home and it's just all around good.
That's awesome.
So just want to get that in there. The other thing, so we have Wonderland Yarns. They are a local to us company. They're down in Brattleboro, Vermont. And this is one of their new kits that they're doing. This is Opposites Attract, and it's two separate skeins. You can see the two separate skeins twisted together. And let's see, the unicorn, which is this lovely one with the sparkles. Is a silk kid mohair nylon and lurex, which is the sparkly, and a bit of magic, it says. And then the Mad Hatter, which we do have is a little bit of this in too, is their 100% superwash merino. And they actually include a free pattern on the label, which is really nice. So I'm going to make up that free pattern.
Awesome.
So these are sold as kits, which is really fun. Look at all that.
We have some of their other kits.
We do.
And people have really enjoyed them.
They're great. Yeah. They make some really...
Takes the guesswork out of it.
Yeah. And if you just want to, you know, you don't know what you want in it, you want something, but you don't want to think about a whole lot.
Here it is all for you right now.
Yeah, they do some, their patterns are really well written, and they're fun, basic, but they're pretty. So, yeah, isn't that, I love that sparkle.
So I expect we'll be getting some of that in the shop.
Yeah, and their colorways are gorgeous.
Yeah.
So that's one thing that we'll probably be bringing in quite soon. And so I'll stick with those guys, too. They are also doing these kits. So, you know, you get gradient and you're not really sure what to do with it. There's a lot of shawls now that are incorporating a full skein of yarn with a gradient kit. They're putting them all together for you.
Oh, nice.
Which is really nice because they're taking, and they have, you know, this one was, you know, pretty basic because, you know, it's the gray gradient here with a really gorgeous burgundy, but they're putting together some really fun colors that, you know, might push you to be like, oh, you know, I really like that together that you wouldn't necessarily think.
You wouldn't normally put them together.
Yeah, so if you sometimes, you know, aren't sure about colors, they're doing it for you, which is really nice. And they do have some really fun patterns. They've got a cowl knit up in one of these, and they also have a shawl pattern, and I have both of those, and I didn't, actually, you know what, I might have a couple. Let me see. I might be able to show them real quick. Yeah.
I sense a large Wonderland Yarns order going in.
I know. Well, we're so low on their gradients already. So there's a little cowl,
which is
really cute. And then, let's see. This is going to be hard to show. There we go. We can do that. Oh, there. So that's the cowl I just showed you. And there's the shawl. And so they obviously did it in a, you know, brighter, louder gradation, but you can kind of get the idea. You use, you know, the main color is going to be the one that's striping, and then you've got the gradient that goes in between. The other pattern I thought of immediately when I saw this is on the Spice Market, which is it's a really nice pattern. It's been out there for a little while now, and a lot of people have been knitting it, and it's gorgeous, and I think this kit would work really well for it. There's more, let's see, there's 5 gradient colors in here. I think that one calls for like 6, so you'd have to play around with it a little bit, but I think it's pretty easy to do that with that. Melanie Berg, I think, is the one who wrote that pattern. And so that kit, you know, we already have some of their gradient kits in, but we might end up bringing some more in that has this extra skein in here.
Well, and the kits are nice, right? Because people don't have to think about matching yarns. It's all right there. It's just a question of, do you like these color combinations?
Yep.
And it just makes it easy.
Yeah. So another really good idea from those guys. Zen Yarn Gardens, we do carry their yarns. This is a new kit. They have some new colors, and let me cover that up. So this is some of their new colorways that they're doing, the Cordoba shawl. I know, isn't that pretty?
That one's nice too. They're all nice. They're all nice.
Yeah. So it's a really nice kit. And they're actually going to start doing some of these really cool, it's kind of like a yarn of the month where you get boxes of yarn, and And the yarn store can bring in as many or as few of the boxes as they want. So people can sign up for them ahead of time and we can pre-order.
Oh.
And then people are starting to do like these unboxing parties. So you send everybody out an email and say, you know, the boxes are due in this day, you know, at knit group or at whatever time, we're all going to get together and open our boxes together.
So it's like a surprise yarn club that's run through the store.
Yeah.
That is awesome.
Yeah. It takes a lot of the, you know, yeah. So you can subscribe to it, but you can do it on a month-to-month basis.
We should do that.
I know.
We should totally do that.
It's really cool. And next year, in January, they're going to start advertising in the fall, but in January, they're going to have basically a square of the month or a blanket stripe of the month kit.
Mm-hmm.
So it's, I think it's an eight month subscription. I mean, you don't have to do all of them, but it'd be silly not to because you wouldn't have the whole blanket. But each month, each of the 8 months, you'll get a box, and in that is the next stripe of color to put onto your blanket. Or
That's cool.
I think they're doing a stripe one, but they might do blocks too. I'm not sure what they're gonna do. I haven't seen
this. That's fun.
Yeah, isn't that fun? So
yeah,
they had some great ideas. So really fun company out of Canada. If you haven't heard of them, Zen Yarn Garden. We do have some of their Serenity 20 yarn here, which is actually the yarn that Angela's going to make that shawl out of she was talking about.
Yes.
And so yeah, really fun ideas. The company's
got cashmere in it.
It does.
How could you say no?
20% cashmere, so it's quite a bit higher than. Than the other ones, which are 5 or 10.
We're so going to have to do the yarn box thing.
Isn't that a cute idea?
That's great.
A lot of the yarn companies are coming up. They know how busy the shop owners are, and it's sometimes hard to, you know, generate a lot of ideas and new things, you know, on a regular basis. So a lot of the yarn companies are starting to do things like this, which helps us out immensely, which helps you guys out, because then we're coming up with new ideas.
New fun things.
Yeah.
Surprise yarn, people. Yeah. It's a reason to have a party.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
And you could probably incorporate like a knit along around with the box arrival of some sort.
Yeah.
Yeah, you could just really have fun with it.
Yeah, so it's, yeah, a lot of fun. And then the last thing that I got is drool worthy.
So that like never ending bag over there.
I know. I have this huge, I've been the bag lady for the last week. I've had a bunch of bags. So. This is Anzula, which they make absolutely gorgeous yarn.
They do.
Super squishy. This is their, which base is this? This is their Ava, which is a sport weight. And it's 80% superwash merino, 10% cashmere, and 10% nylon. So it's their MCN base, and it's a sport weight. Really super squishy. This is their Frankie colorway. And the kit that they had a couple different kits they were doing, and this is the one that I really liked. And it is the Mother of Dragons shawl, which, if you guys are
Game of Thrones reference
familiar, then this is what that is referring to.
Nice.
But the shawl is really, really pretty. So I don't know if we're going to bring Anzula in or not. I would love to. They do really lovely luxury hand dyed yarns.
Yeah.
Really nice company, really great company. I mean, I say that about all the companies, so I mean, there's a lot of really great companies out there.
It's hard to choose.
Yeah. So, and not all of the stores did sample it, but we did. Some of them actually sold out of their product before we actually
got to some of their
booths. We actually were, so they set it up so that there are four lanes, A, B, C, and D, and you went up before the sample it and got a tag basically so that you could stand in line and they put you in numerical order so there wasn't supposed to be as much pushing.
Kind of like Flying Southwest.
Yeah, exactly. That's what they referred to it as. And so there wouldn't be pushing and shoving and things like that. But I
Did
mean,
it help?
Maybe a little bit, but I mean, they let one lane after the other go. So it wasn't like you got time in there.
Before more people came in.
Yeah. So it wasn't very long that we had in there before all of a sudden was just people everywhere. And
so those are just your spoils, right? So Jen has a whole bag of spoils herself.
Jen does have a bag of spoils. She actually had to unzip the part of her suitcase that makes it bigger because we did just carry-ons. And yeah, so she's got more. She's got some other stuff. So we'll have to. She's actually out of town right now. So
I'll have to get her
in
here. She may have to fill in for me for a week or so.
So sample it was fun. We saw a lot of new yarns. Saw some fun people. Stephen B was there.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So he's I saw him both on Friday and Saturday, and he was busy talking to people, so I didn't really get a chance to go up and introduce myself and say hi. We were gonna meet up with the knit girls. They were so busy. I actually only saw. It was funny. I saw Laura for like 2 seconds. I was walking in a different row, going the opposite direction of her, and she was going the other way. And I turned and I saw her. And I was like, "Oh, they are here. I'll have to go catch up with them."
And
then the rest of the night, I was like, "They just like vanished. I didn't see them at all the rest of the night." And then I know they were on the floor on Saturday, and because I kept getting Instagram updates, and I saw, Laura was just by. There was a giant felted dinosaur. It was adorable. I think Jen got a picture of it. Well, if you go to TNNA's Facebook page, they have some great pictures. Or just do check out hashtag TNNA show on Instagram, and you'll see some really, really fun pictures. Yep. But there's a giant felted dinosaur, and I saw a larva, and I was like, I was just there. And I was like, I didn't see her. So they must have been either like just ahead of us or just behind us. But I never saw Laura and Leslie on the floor except for on my Instagram feed. And I was like, this is so bizarre.
That's so bizarre.
Yeah. It was really bizarre. But the show floor was huge.
Huge.
So there's aisle after aisle. I think there were like seven or eight aisles. And each aisle was really long. Wow. And I think I did take some pictures. I took pictures at Sample It of the masses of people.
Yeah.
But they're kind of blurry, so if there's any that came out okay, I'll give them to Ange, and she can put some pictures in at the end. And I took a picture with Jen Lucas. She's a great designer. She has a new book that's coming out, so there's a picture of us,
nice.
Jen and I, on Instagram with her. So she was sweet, and that was the fun part. We got to talk to some designers.
Nice.
But we didn't end up taking as much pictures or videos as we wanted to because we were carrying around like bags of stuff, and we had books in our arms
and samples,
yeah. And you know, there's a lot of people, so we really didn't, you know, we didn't end up doing as much as we would have liked to have. But it was a good experience. We didn't buy a lot. Oh, one thing for everybody out there. So we did buy a couple things while we were there. A couple new companies. Sheikah, I mentioned before. They've got the needle cases and project bags and little notions bags, and they use a laminated fabric, so you can just wipe it off. So if you go to knit groups or if you're knitting outside, things like that, it keeps your yarn clean and dry, and you can just wipe them off the outside. And,
excellent.
Yeah, they're really nice, bright, bold colors. So we've got some of those coming right away. Some of them are shipping a little bit later because it's their new color.
Awesome.
The other company that we ordered from, sort of an order, is Pom Pom Magazine. So if you guys are familiar, it's a British publication. We've got Pom Pom Magazine coming.
Excellent.
They're going to send us their summer issue.
Okay. Because they're out quarterly, right?
Yes. Pom Pom Quarterly is actually what it's called officially. They also have gotten into publishing books. They have they've published Interpretations, which in 1, 2, and 3, which is Hohe Locatelli and Vera Valamaki's books that they did jointly.
Which are amazing.
All three of them
that
are beautiful. We do have copies of those coming in. I know. So, yeah, so we've got hard copies. They did release it online on Ravelry as an ebook, but we are going to have the hard copies in, which are lovely.
Nice.
Really, really lovely. So, yeah, we're going to be having issues of Pom Pom in the store. We're going to be listed on their website, so if you're wondering where to buy it, you can buy it from us. So those are the two things that we actually did buy when we were there. Everything else, we really just wanted to get a feel for a lot of the different yarns that are out there. We stopped at Sweet Georgia's booth, and
they have beautiful yarns.
They have really lovely yarns, so we've got information from them. We stopped at Space Cadet. They've got really lovely yarns. Another, you know, smaller dyer.
Was Leading Men Fiber Arts there?
I didn't see them. I didn't see that they were there. Oh my gosh, there were so many booths. There's a new yarn company out of Canada called Sugarbush Yarns, and we stopped at their booth.
Nice.
They're really lovely. They've got some unique yarns, more commercial type yarns that you'll see. They're not, you know, smaller hand dyeing, but really interesting texturally, and they're right up in Canada.
Excellent.
I think they're Toronto area, I think.
Okay.
Don't hold me to that, but I think that's where they're from. What else did we see? Oh my gosh, there's so many. Three Irish girls was there, and their booth was busy the whole time, so I really didn't get a chance to stop. But, you know, a lot of these companies are ones that we can touch base with
right.
later. And who else was there? Oh my gosh, there's a lot of people were there. So I ended up taking a couple classes. The classes were phenomenal.
Nice.
One of the classes I ended up taking was a teaching-based class, and I took that with Jane Patrick, who is involved with Shocked Spindle Company, and she was wonderful. And if we do bring spinning supplies in, Shocked is one company that I would lean towards. I have a matchless, and they make beautiful wheels, and they do have some kind of more entry level wheels, the Sidekick and the Ladybug,
yeah.
Which are both really great wheels, and not even just entry level starting wheels. They're good. They're just good all around wheels. Great travel wheels to, you know, if you go to knit groups and things like that.
Excellent.
So, excellent. Yeah.
That was good. And then you took a social media class.
I took a social media savvy class, and that was phenomenal. Yeah, really, really great classes. Two teachers taught that class. One was the visual side of it, photography. She was fantastic. Nice. The other was the written part of it. And, you know, how to really...
Because both are important.
They really are. I mean, a lot of people see the image first, so you have to have an image that's very striking, and then you want a short, concise synopsis of what the picture is about.
Yeah.
So I learned a lot of really great information in that class. TNNA did a fantastic job
Excellent.
With their education, and I only heard good things about that. So
nice.
It was definitely worth it for even just that part of it.
Excellent.
So, yeah.
Excellent. So watch out. We're going to be social mediaized more than we are already.
We try to be pretty good, but
yeah.
There are some weeks when it's just tough to get it in. But
yeah.
But yeah. So I've been trying to put up pictures of new products and different things as we go. So, yeah, kind of.
Excellent.
Keep your eyes on our social media. We're trying to keep everybody involved and.
Keep in touch,
and I wasn't as good as I hoped to have been at TNNA with video and pictures, but you'd understand why if I actually had taken any video and pictures.
Yeah.
It was a very busy day.
Like Rhinebeck busy?
Yeah, well, it wasn't
different.
Quite, yeah, it was definitely different because it's a different vibe because, well, sample it reminded me of Indian Tangled.
Okay.
So if you went to Indian Tangled, that's kind of what sample it was like. Just people everywhere and, like, you know,
chaos.
Crowding to get into
chaos.
The booth. Yeah, so it was a little bit like that. But the show itself, especially late in the afternoon, because a lot of people go for 2 or 3 days. I mean, we were there for multiple days, but Saturday, Sunday, and Monday are the days the actual trade show floor is open. So we were only there on Saturday for when the trade show floor was open. We left on Sunday. So a lot of people didn't have to make the big decisions on Saturday. They were there just
browse.
To get an idea of who was there, what they wanted to come back to, and if they're going to buy, they would do it, you know, Sunday or Monday before they left. And we were, you know, we were really there just to kind of scope things out. And so it really tailed off in the late afternoon, and which was kind of nice, but we were so exhausted because we had been on our feet all day long. So we were definitely ready to catch up. We ended up having dinner with Katie from Katrinkles.
Nice.
Which was really nice. And then Maureen from Green Mountain Spinnery. So hi and thank you. And
nice.
It was fun. We got to catch up with them, which is, you know, you don't always get to put faces to names. You know, we're working with different vendors and you don't always get to meet them, but it was nice to be able to do that and just connect with people and other shops that, you know, that was a lot of what I found was really interesting, connecting and hearing what they're doing to for programs for their customers or classes for their customers, you know, getting some good ideas of things that you guys might like. So it was a really great experience
right.
that way. So.
Well, and speaking of shops and other shops, we have coming up the Yarn Hall.
We do have the Yarn Hall, yeah. So
starts in July.
Yep.
And Saturday, the 18th, is Knit in Public Day.
It is. Yeah, I'm going to put together some door prizes. So if you guys are in the area, I'm just going to, you know, have a little basket or something. Just drop your name in, and I'm going to, you know, throughout the day, I'll just be randomly drawing out some prizes. We'll probably do some stitch markers. I might even grab one of the project bags that we've got, and and some yarn. We've got some fun yarn that I'm going to pull out. So,
excellent.
Yeah, so we're going to have some fun little giveaways and little rewards for saying thanks for stopping by and hanging out with us.
Excellent.
And I think some of our knit group, they're going to at least come by for a little bit.
It's supposed to be nice on Saturday.
Supposed to be gorgeous, and we've got a little out front, the trees are nice and shady in the afternoon.
Bring a lawn chair,
bring some snacks, and you know, it's going to be kind of low key. It's going to be kind of like our knit group, but you know, just a fun time to get together with everybody. And I think Carol's going to pop in for a little bit. So.
I might pop in, depending on, maybe. We'll see.
Yeah, so, you know, very informal, but just fun, relaxing afternoon or morning. So we're open 10 to 5 on Saturday. So you're welcome to come and knit during any of that time.
Or it's, you know, out on the lawn. So if you want to get here at 9.
Well, yes. Absolutely.
Why not?
You can come, you know.
Totally fine. We won't be here per se, but
yeah. Yeah, so anyway, I think it'll be fun, just this fun informal group with, you know, some little prizes thrown in.
Yeah, and fun.
Yeah, so
awesome.
It'll be a good day.
Nice. So if you're driving by on Route 7, honk at our knitters.
Yeah, we'll wave.
And we'll wave or wave our knitting at you.
Yeah, so it'll be fun. And then we've got our regular knit group on Sunday from 1 to 3. And don't forget our trunk shows.
Yes, the KnitBot ones are in.
The KnitBot's in, and we've got Botanical Knits soon. We'll be packing those up. I'm going to be packing them up on Monday because they have to turn around and go back out to California.
Yeah.
So, unfortunately, the KnitBot one we didn't get to have for very long, but it is here, and there's some really lovely pieces.
Featherweight. If you want to see a finished featherweight.
Yep, featherweight, the one that was actually in the book, is here, which it's great. And, yeah, so you can see a finished one, the original. And
what started it all.
Yeah. So we've got some of the individual patterns and the KnitBot book. The Botanical Knits book we did sell out of, but I just ordered more yesterday, and they shipped out at the end of the day yesterday.
So we should get them.
So they are coming from California. So it'll be next week before we get them. But we can always put one on hold for you. So if that's something that you want to do, we can certainly do that.
Yeah, they're beautiful books.
Yeah. Oh, and their Baby Botanical Knits just came out, and I ordered some of those. So those are coming in, too.
Nice.
They're adorable. They're like little kids' versions of the classic.
That's the mini-me's.
Yeah, they're adorable. So those books are coming in. So
nice.
Yeah.
Yay.
Yeah. So we've got some fun stuff coming in, and trying to keep it really lively around here and bringing in new things. And
I think, are you going to put some more classes up in July?
Probably not sure about July. So, okay. We're talking to, Amy at Vivid.
Oh, okay.
Which I was going to mention, I mentioned it briefly to Jen. She's got some availability in August.
Oh.
So August, we might be having some
dyeing
class. Color theory, knitting with color, picking color. She's got gorgeous colors.
Book it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So she has amazing yarn.
She does. And we'll link to her website so you can see what that's all about. And so we're going to have Amy come in and do some of that.
Fantastic.
Which summer is the perfect time to do some dyeing classes.
Because we can do it outside.
Because we can do it outside.
And maybe we can get some of her great aunts in too at the same time.
Yeah. So we can at least do a trunk show with her and do that. So we're going to do that, and we're going to start up some of our classes. Our biggest thing right now is just, you know, getting coverage for classes is the hardest thing in the summer because everybody has trips and things like that. So that's been has made us back away from classes. But we're going to start doing that, getting the classes schedule going again, and we may even do some on Thursdays. Thursdays are a little easier for us because we've got, you know, a couple of us here. So we might do, if we had talked about doing some of the kids' classes, so we might try to do that.
Like an afternoon or something.
Before school gets going again.
Okay, excellent.
Yeah, So keep an eye on that. We always send out, you know, we've got our email list. You can sign up for that on our website if you want. And Facebook, Instagram, you know, I try to keep those all updated with what's new and what's going on and what's coming up. So nice. So on any of those formats, you'll probably see some updates coming soon with different things that we're gonna be doing. So
excellent.
Yeah.
Sounds good.
Yeah. I know. Are you tired of listening to me?
don't mind me, the silent person over here.
Oh, and the other thing, one of the other things, we did get some books. There, a lot of the authors were actually signing books at TNNA, which was really lovely. And I did pick up, I'm not going to talk a lot about this right now. I want to look through it a little bit more and I can give you a better review of the book. But Refined Knits, there's some really lovely patterns in here.
Nice.
Really lovely, very feminine patterns. So Jennifer Wood was there and she signed this book for me.
Excellent.
But yeah, there's some really, really great patterns. So I'm going to look through this a little bit more and we'll do a more structured review of it.
Okay.
in the next coming weeks or so and go from there. But I think that pretty much covers everything. I'm sure I've missed a few things. Oh, I'll show you one of the fun patterns from Chica that we're getting.
Oh, excellent.
The little strawberry. So this is just a little free paperwork pouch or, you know, knitting pouch or whatever you want to use for. I've got a lot of paperwork in here that I collected from TNNA.
It's probably waterproof, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know because of the zipper,
but
it's water resistant for sure. And so this is one of the patterns that we've got coming in, the strawberries, which is really fun.
Nice.
So, so that's that. And
awesome.
I think we're at an hour, so we can probably wrap it up. Do you have anything else that you want to?
No.
I'm glad we got to squeeze at least one more in
before
we take a little break. But
at the rate we're going, or at the rate I'm going, we're not taking any breaks.
I know. So, yeah. So I think I've covered. Oh, I forgot this. This yarn. So Eternal Effects yarn. And this... I met with the sales rep who actually reps this. She was at the Cocoa Knits booth. And so I saw her there and she's like, oh yeah, I rep that yarn. So it was perfect timing. It's really lovely, really lovely yarn. So I'm just going to briefly show it to you. It might be another yarn that we're considering, but I don't know. It fell out of my bag, so I missed it.
Forgot.
But anyway, so if you're still hanging on and watching us.
Thanks for staying to the bitter end.
Yeah. We had a lot of stuff to go over. And so we stayed very knitting oriented today or yarn oriented today.
Instead of listening to Kelly and Angela talk about random stuff like the robin that built a bird's nest in my hanging basket with an egg. I'll put a picture in.
I have cardinals.
Yeah.
Right outside my door that have a nest.
Yeah.
Four little baby cardinals.
Oh, we have two Phoebe nests on our porch.
Oh too. My gosh.
It's like bird central out there.
Yeah, it's great. Vermont, you end up wildlife, right? I mean, I live like out in the country, so
we've
got, you know, wildlife walking through all the time. So,
it's exciting.
But, yeah, so anyway, thank you for watching.
By.
We appreciate it. And
we hope you come back.
They'll want to see all the other fun stuff that we end
up
bringing.
I know, because apparently Jen has a whole other bag of things for us to talk
about. Jen has a bunch of stuff, and then when the Chica comes in and the pom-pom mag, we'll do reviews of that when we get that. And so we're going to have all kinds of fun stuff coming up in classes and things like that.
And the fall yarns are supposed to be arriving.
We're going to have
July.
Some fall yarns starting to come. Madeline Tosh. I just paid for the Madeline Tosh. So after you pay for it, that means the next step is it goes to getting dyed. So next week, I think they said
excellent.
Next week it's going to go into the queue for dyeing.
Excellent.
So then it should be another week or so. So
early July.
We're looking at early July. We'll probably have the Madeline Tosh. So if you've been waiting for that.
It's apparently happening.
It's happening. So yeah, I got the notice that they said they want money. So I gave them some money. And so they're going to.
Here, take my money.
Yeah. So they're going to be dyeing that. Next week, probably.
Awesome.
We've got some of their new colorways coming. The Electric Rainbow, if you've seen that, it's very bright. It's very cool. So, yeah, that's coming. So
that'll be a big announcement. Look for that on social media. Kelly's going to put
when I open the box.
Social media skills to good use.
Yeah, so we're going to have all kinds of fun stuff. So we'd love to have you come back and watch us and when we do our next episode, we're not sure exactly when it's going to be, but we're going to have a lot of fun stuff to talk about when
we'll
we do.
We'll figure it out. It might be a short episode, but we'll figure it out.
But yeah, thanks for watching,
right,
and
you.
We'll see you next time.
See you soon.
Bye.
Fabulous, huh? Look at all of this stuff. Okay, that's a whip. That's a whip, but it's new. This is new product. Oops,
new.
That's
TNNA. We got all kinds of stuff to talk about today. But if you're listening to this video, you've already heard it.
A little test.
Earthquake. Are our heads still cut off? Kind of. Not really. That's not bad. How am I tall? Is my chair higher than yours? How am I taller than you?
You're just taller than me.
Thank you.